We're rolling.
Okay. All right, guys. Another edition of my Gym Rat Chit Chat. Today I'm talking to Lisa Zahn. Lisa has been a member with us for a little while, and now she is starting to coach.
Yeah.
So we're gonna ask Lisa a few questions. Let's start with, how long have you been at CPM?
2 years.
Just got my 2 years.
Yeah, nice. So you started, I'm trying to think, that would be 2015,
yes.
Right? What brought you to CPM? How did you discover it, or how did it discover you?
I came to CPM as I was doing Spartan races, OCR races, and I was reading about training, and they said CrossFit.
Okay.
So Shannon and I were going to try a couple different gyms out, mm-hmm. and we came and never left. And now I've kind of left OCR for CrossFit.
Yeah. You switched it up. I remember your first workout, because it was a partner workout, and you and I partnered up. Do you remember that?
Yep, kind of.
I vaguely remember we were going to have some new girls in class, and I partnered up with you. Anyway, I remember that. What made you think it might be a good idea to join CPM? Like, what did you like about it?
I really liked the community aspect. Well, and it was something that scared me. I don't know. I really like, there's barbell. It's all different stuff,
yeah.
too.
Yeah.
So I think once I came, I was just hooked because of the variety, mm-hmm. and I really like challenges.
Yeah.
And I love that there's small challenges along the way. So I think that's kind of what gave me, you know, got me hooked.
Sure.
Once
sure.
There's always things to achieve, but then once you get them, there's always other things to achieve. There's always things to work on.
Yeah.
But it keeps you motivated and satisfied along the way.
Mm-hmm. I think that's a great way to describe it. And like, if any of you ever work out with Lisa, you would know that she has some very high skill sets in some things. Like, she can walk on her hands, very good at muscle ups, handstand push ups, things like that, which I think will make you really fun to have as a coach to teach people some of that stuff. So Wednesday nights, guys,
come
to her class. Who is your favorite athlete? Because I know you follow the athletes. Who's your favorite athlete?
I know, I've been thinking about this question for like 2 weeks and I can talk for like 10 minutes. I don't know if I can name a favorite because I follow stories and I love the process. Instead of like the achievement of the athlete, I love their process.
Okay.
So I shared it today. On the male side, it would have to be Pat Vellner.
I love Pat Vellner.
Mainly because he doesn't take it too seriously. He quotes all the time that if you're in the gym for more than 2 hours a day, he doesn't know what the heck you're doing.
And he's an amazing athlete.
Yes.
And he's getting by without doing more than that.
And I really like supporting the athletes who have life outside. I mean, I think that if you make a sport your life, you should be winning.
Yes.
Or be an elite athlete.
That's your profession.
Yeah. So Pat Vellner, I love all the females. Cara Webb is my favorite of the females. I don't know why, but I've always been drawn to her.
I think that's interesting because she's not one that I've ever really, no. I mean, I like her, but she's not one that I've ever been really
especially
drawn
lately,
to.
like I said, if you follow the story and she does not, she also is somebody who doesn't put her life on the internet, but if you read about her, I think she's had some pretty dark pasts and she's overcome a lot of stuff.
Yeah.
Sarah Seaman's daughter at the games she won over everybody's heart. She was somebody I really disliked until the games, and we saw her at the games and you learned her backstory, and again, she's overcome like all this confidence issues. She's amazing. Katrin's always smiling. She's always supporting the other athletes.
Yeah.
I don't want to like winners for some reason, but Katrin, I mean, she's nothing but graceful.
Yeah.
And when she was seventh in the games this year after coming in first twice, her thing was, I liked to fight. You know?
Yeah.
You know, I'm sure she was disappointed.
Yeah.
But she said it was her favorite games because it gave her reason to fight.
Yeah.
I think that's a cool reason.
Awesome. Yeah, they're so fun. I love watching them, guys. If you don't watch any of the athletes yet, you gotta follow them on Instagram.
They're just fun.
It's so fun. Yeah. And they have some of them are really funny too.
They are. They don't take life seriously.
No. So what makes you laugh at the gym? What makes you have fun or laugh? Is there anything here?
Marin.
That's funny, because that's what makes me laugh too.
I'm somebody who I feel like I take life and the gym a little bit too seriously.
I don't believe that.
So I tend to be a little conservative. So what makes me laugh? Just people, I don't know, who are funny.
Yeah, like when they do funny.
Yeah, I really like working out with people who don't take it too seriously.
Yeah, I would.
I would like to emulate that. I don't think I do, but I would like to emulate that I don't take it seriously.
I don't think people always know.
Yeah.
I think, you know, it's hard to tell sometimes how serious someone is taking things. What makes you mad at the gym?
What makes me mad at the gym?
Yeah, like what frustrates you during class?
I don't like people who are competitive versus practicing, if you listen to Ben Bergeron. I don't like people who cheat reps. I think you're better doing full range of motion and learning to engage the proper muscles and doing the proper movement versus coming in 5 minutes before somebody. So
yeah.
I don't use the word cheating because I don't really care if people cheat. That's on you, and I actually feel more sad than mad.
Yeah.
But I think if you want to, I mean, the whole reason we're at CPM is functional fitness is so you can do better in your functional life. So do the full range of motion.
Yeah.
And if that means doing 8 instead of 10, do 8 instead of 10. But do the full range. That's probably the worst thing.
Yeah, I would agree with you there. Are you competitive? So you just talked about this.
I say I'm not.
You told me you're not, and I'm like.
Everybody else in the gym tells me I. So I'm competitive in the sense of if I know I can do it, I'm competitive. But I'm also very smart in how old I am compared to other people and my ability level. And so I'm not mad like coming in second or fifth or tenth.
Yeah.
But am I competitive in that? I know where people are at, and I know where how to push myself. Yeah.
Okay.
But if my body's not feeling it that day, I'm not competitive, and that you'll never see me hurt myself again.
Yeah.
You know, to win.
Yep.
So I'm probably competitive in that I watch people and I know my own ability.
Yeah.
But I don't. I feel like super competitive people they could not be feeling it and they'll still win. And I don't have that mental capacity.
Yeah.
I'm like, no, my body's feeling this today. So I'm gonna go 80% for me.
Yeah. I'm similar. I used to be a little more on the other side, but I'm trying to be smarter and smarter because it is not worth it.
Right.
Being out for 3 months, 6 months, whatever, you and I both know.
Yeah.
It's not worth the win. I can tell you that much. Is it true that you drink 2 caribou lattes every day?
Only on the weekdays. Not the weekends.
You guys.
But it is.
This is important
secret
stuff
sauce.
To know. This
secret
is
sauce.
This is so important. What is your secret sauce?
Oh, it's just
almond milk, right?
Almond milk. But I do put white chocolate chips in there. So people who, I do eat super healthy and I know how to eat healthy, but that is what I kept was my sugar in my, so I do a white chocolate mocha with almond milk.
You know, I love, like if I can have my one thing a day or my 2 things a day and then eat the rest healthy, I love that.
Yeah.
It gives me something to look forward to.
And my friends then say that's my normalcy. Like one of my friends, because I eat super healthy, she's like, I love that you kept that.
Yeah. So I think it's awesome. And it makes you very real. Too. I think that's great.
I do.
Any parting thoughts? Anything you want to add? Gym wise, tips for people.
Oh gosh. Don't be afraid to talk to coaches this is Emily's chit chat, but me, like I love to see people achieve something they want. If you come to my evening classes, I've said like if you could do one movement, like what's one thing you could do? Because like today we did overhead squats. And the movement I remember is I was in the corner trying to do overhead squats. I was fairly new. I could have been 6 months into it though.
Yeah.
And Emily finally just went, I don't even know what to do with you. Kind of.
Just stretch.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm a gymnast. I'm like, I couldn't figure out how to do an overhead squat. And eventually it'll come.
Just gotta be patient.
Patience is key. And that's one thing I love about doing functional fitness is you have to be patient. You can't rush the movements.
Yeah.
But I think it's just don't be afraid to try. Like this is not a gym where people don't look at you and laugh.
Yeah.
It's really, really fun for the coaches to see you guys achieve things. So
absolutely.
Don't be afraid to say, hey, I want to do this. How do I get there? But then put in the work and don't be afraid if the coach tells you my overhead squats. It's like, it's my shoulders. And I'm always like, it's your ankle. Like, it's my shoulders. It was totally my ankles.
Yeah.
So listen to the coaches too.
Yeah. Yeah. And like, I love that you said, don't be afraid to try. My personal favorite is when people try muscle ups. I love seeing someone get them, and you're never going to know unless you try.
Right.
You know, but talk about something that makes you nervous.
Yeah.
I mean, failing's tough.
And for the record, for the Granite Games, I flopped around on the rings for 12 minutes.
Yeah.
During muscle up on video.
I remember
so
that.
Don't be afraid to look foolish because we have 12 minutes of video of
just
me flopping around.
Try it.
And I
different. Awesome. Well, thanks, Lisa, for chatting today.
Thank you.
I'm looking forward to having you coach a lot at CPM.
Yes.
It's going to be awesome. Bye, guys.
All right. Perfect. That was good.